Just like your car, your boat engine requires regular oil changes. Most manufacturers recommend that you do that every 100 hours or once per year, whichever comes first. Hey, Mark Cork here from BoatUS Magazine, and today I'm going to change the oil on my engine. I like to do that in the fall so that the engine will have fresh oil in it over the winter time. Internal components will be protected, and come the spring I'll be back on the water that much sooner. You won't need a ton of materials, but what you will need is obviously oil of the correct grade and quantity as recommended by your engine manufacturer, a Ziploc bag for an old oil filter, disposable gloves, filter wrench, new oil filter, oil absorbent sheets, and plenty of clean rags, and finally a container to store the used oil in. Before changing the oil, I'm going to start the engine and let it warm up to normal operating temperature. That ensures that any contaminants in the old oil will be held in suspension and will be pumped out when I change the oil. No matter how careful you are, there's a chance that you're going to spill some oil, so a good amount of oil absorbent pads is a great idea. I have a manual pump built onto the side of the engine. Another option is to use an oil change pump, which goes down the dipstick hole and sucks the oil out that way. Either will work, but we need to keep pumping until all the oil is out of the engine. So I keep pumping until I hear gurgling and I know I can't suck any more oil out the engine. After using a filter wrench to loosen the filter, I then get a Ziploc bag and put this over the filter and continue to undo it by hand. Make sure you've got sufficient oil absorbent pads below it. After you've removed the filter, make sure that the sealing ring comes off with it. With the bag back the right way round and the oil filter in there, I can zip that up and that will contain any spills, and now we can just dispose of that properly. Smear a little oil onto the seal on the new filter so it will make a good fit and it won't leak next time. Put a little bit in the threads too and it will come off easily. And it's a great idea to write the date and the amount of engine hours on the side of the filter. And then we're going to screw that on. Just do it up hand tight. Just bear in mind when you're filling up the engine that we don't want to overfill the engine, and that's almost as bad as having too little in the engine. After letting your oil settle for a few minutes, pull the dipstick and check the level. If it's low, you may need to add a little bit more oil. After refilling with oil, I double check everything. I can then start the engine and check for leaks. So now all that's left to do is just to recycle the old oil. So there you have it. Took me about an hour to do. The engine will be protected during the winter months, and come the spring it'll be one less thing to worry about. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like, subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave any comments below. Also check out our winterization playlist for more helpful how-to videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the water.